Hey guys, happy Monday. How was your weekend? I hope it was great. Mine was nice. It went fast. Of course, the weekends always go so fast, and then Monday's here before you open your eyes. Anyways, I just want to talk real quick about one of my residents. This weekend, yesterday, I would say, he woke up Saturday morning into Sunday, I would say. He woke up about 4 a.m., he got up, he walked to the bathroom, did what he had to do, and then he got into the hallway between his bedroom and between the hallway, and he sat on the floor and says, "I can't walk anymore. I need to go to the hospital." So my staff said, "Come on, you can get up, you can walk." "No, I can't walk anymore. I don't want to walk anymore. I can't walk anymore." So she said, "Well, can you or can't you?" "I can, but I don't want to walk. I want to go to the hospital." And he's just going on and on and on and on and on and on. So finally, about 10 a.m., I believe my staff texted me and said that this gentleman was up to his old shenanigans and he wanted to go to the hospital. I said, "Listen, call 911. I'm tired of dealing with the same thing." So she called 911, and he was still sitting on the floor. He would not get up. So maybe it was like 8 a.m., not 10 a.m., it was like 8 a.m. And I said, "Call." But guess what? He's not coming back. I'm tired of going back and forth. And with the whole COVID, you're not going in the hospital. I'm coming back and going to the, I'm not doing that. So she called 911 and they took him yesterday. And I immediately contacted the family members. I emailed the one that's in another state that's taking on the responsibility of taking care of him. And power of attorney who actually lives here has COVID, and she's like, "Well, what am I supposed to do? I can't do anything." Okay. He's actually supposed to be moving out on October 10th. So I've been corresponding with the potential new assistant living community that he's going to. So basically what I did was I did an emergency discharge, meaning in the contract, you can give somebody an emergency discharge, but that's based off of them being a harm to themselves or a harm to others in the home, or basically you not being able to continue to keep them safe as a resident. So that's how I did the discharge, as an emergency discharge, that he is a harm to himself and that I can no longer, as a provider, provide care to keep him safe. So I'm here at work right now just typing up everything just so if the state comes and they ask if I had a such and such, if I had such and such here, I can say, "Hey, yes, this person lived here and this is why they were discharged as an emergency." And then I have all my documentation that I need to provide to them. So, you know, hopefully, you know, when he does go to his other facility, that everything works out. I'm just not, you know, no longer a good fit for him. And I'm okay with that, you know. But then on the flip side, you know, and please don't take this the wrong way, this business is like a revolving door. He left yesterday and I already had a virtual tour for a male for his bed. So that's how fast clients come and that's as fast as they go. So don't get discouraged if you are a provider and, you know, you have to discharge someone due to an emergency or if they move out for whatever reason. There are other clients out here that do need your services or that want to move into your community. So that's a position I'm in. As I mentioned, yesterday was an emergency discharge and I already got a call today and we did a virtual tour for a male. So that's part of the business. You know, as I mentioned, I hope that he does find a great home. The provider that I did speak to about 2 weeks ago, she seemed nice. I never saw the facility. I did ask the family if they even saw a virtual tour of the facility and or pictures, and they said no. But you know what? At the end of the day, it's no longer my responsibility. It's not up to me to try to figure out what type of facility he is going to. It's up to the family. So again, if you guys are in this business and you are providers and you know, you're concerned about discharging someone and they're no longer a good fit for you, you can do an emergency discharge if they are a threat to themselves or others. So that's exactly what I did for this individual. I am no longer going to deal with this. I'm not going to go back and forth with him. I'm not going to go back and forth with the family, trying to make them understand that, you know what, he's not a good fit for me and I'm not a good fit for him. And it's okay. Sometimes relationships, they end for whatever reason. So on that note, I just wanted to give you a little information about emergency discharging someone from your facility. All right. Happy Monday. Have a great week and I'll talk to you soon.